masters and welcome guests. Friends, I am so proud of Ranjan. He is not only an ideal gentleman, but also a responsible son. It was 14 January 1957 when my son's cry broke the silence of the night. Delighted, I held him in my arm and immediately named him Ranjan. Ranjan, one who delights everyone. Ranjan was a wonderful kid, so full of life and energy. I still remember him clapping his hand and laughing out loud. Friends, that laughter still resonates and washes away all the weariness. Ranjan was also an intelligent kid. He was smarter than all his friends, be it maths, science, English, or any other subject. He aced it. I sensed a prodigy. I started nurturing his talent, and buoyed by my encouragement, he started working hard. His hard work and dedication led him to IIT Kharagpur. I pushed him harder. He went even further. He went to MIT and then to Stanford. There was no stopping. He was doing whatever I said. He never questioned me. How could he? He was so naive. He didn't know life. I never let him know life. Once back in college, he asked me if he could go to Digha with his friends. I politely said no. I reminded him of the test coming up next week. From then on, he was on to his studies 24/7 and 365 days a year. My wife, she asked me to cut him loose, to let him live. But I ignored her, because he is going to live my dream. He is going to make me proud. So how could I let him lose focus? After all, it's going to do him well. He will have a happy and a plentiful life. Few years later, my wife, she told me, Ranjan was not happy. He felt a void in his life. He wanted to leave everything and indulge in clock trotting. As usual, I ignored my wife, thinking he just needs a responsibility. I called him back and got him married to the most fair girl I found in Guwahati. Friends, from then on, I never heard a complaint, either from him or his mother. From that time onwards, he worked hard, he earned big bonuses, he went on business tours, he bought expensive items, he even gifted me expensive items. Back home, he made me a big house. I was so happy and so blind. I just saw the riches he was providing and showed it to everyone else. I died a happy father. But friends, I have never been happy thereafter. Because he is not happy. Whenever he looks up the sky, the sadness in his eyes makes me crestfallen. It makes me reach out to him, hug him and say, I'm sorry, son. Go. Live life the way you want. But I can't. If only I could go back in time, I would let him go to Digha with his friend. At least he would not be alone. If only I could go back in time, I would let him play instead of studies. At least his kids would have a father to play with. Friends, I am so proud of Ranjan. Not only was he an ideal gentleman, he was a responsible son. Oh God, what have I done? I have sinned. I have sacrificed my son's life for my pride. My ego blinded me. Otherwise, I would have seen. I had a wife, but she was an unhappy mother. I had a daughter-in-law, but she didn't have a husband. I had grandkids, but they didn't have their father. What have I done? How many lives I have spoiled? For what? For those shiny medals? If only I could have cut him a slack, life would have been so different and so good.